Hi guys, Mike from CCTV Camera Pros here. In this video, I'm gonna demonstrate the Viewtron security camera app for Android. And I'm at CCTV Camera Pros office right now, and I'm gonna remotely connect to my home security camera system. My home security camera system right now consists of a Viewtron NVR and six Viewtron IP cameras, but the Viewtron security camera app for Android, it can also connect to Viewtron BNC DVRs, and it looks exactly the same. So it supports connecting to Viewtron NVRs, Viewtron CCTV DVRs, and it can also connect directly to Viewtron IP cameras, even if they're not connected to an NVR. Let's take a look. Here's the live security camera view in the Viewtron Android app. And in this six camera view, what I can do is I can drag any of the cameras over to that larger screen that I want displayed there. So I'm just gonna drag a couple of them over so you can see how easy it is to manipulate this live view and reposition the cameras. So next I'm going to tap on the screen and I'm going to show you how you can change the view from that six camera view to a four camera grid view. And then in the four camera grid view, if I double tap on any of the cameras, it'll bring up the full screen view of that camera. And notice that when I switch to the single camera view, the video resolution goes to high def. So when you're viewing multiple cameras, it's a lower resolution, so the app performs better. But when you go to a full screen single camera view, it shows a higher definition video stream. So I've been swiping to the left to just switch to the different single camera views. And you can swipe left or right to go back and forth between those. And then next, I'm gonna tap on the screen and click that playback button that you saw in the lower right. And that opens up the video player screen. So now I'm querying the NVR for recorded video, and I can expand that timeline by spreading or pinching to contract it. And then on that timeline, you'll notice most of it is blue. That's where continuous recording is being done. And then those yellow notches that you see on the timeline, those are actually AI detection events. So when a human was detected, and you can also have video motion detection events notated that same way. It just makes it very easy to jump to any of the events that the DVR or NVR supports. So this is video playback. This is streaming the recorded video from the NVR's hard drive remotely to the Android app that I'm accessing from the office here. And then in the playback screen, you can also switch camera views from the single camera view to the multi-camera view the same way as in the live view. So I'll switch to the four camera view. And then if I double tap on the screen on the video player, it'll switch to playing back video just for that single security camera. And again, you can swipe from right to left to go to switch between cameras. And if you tap on the screen, you could bring up that timeline. So I'll just switch to a couple of the other single camera views, and then when I'm done, I'll switch back to the six camera view.
Guys, I think you'll agree that the live security camera viewing from the Android app, as well as the recorded video playback, works extremely well. If you have any questions about any of this, feel free to reach out to me anytime. If you have questions, if you want a quote, whatever you need, just email me at mike@cctvcamerapros.net. If you want to see additional demo videos of this security camera app for Android, please visit www.cctvcamerapros.com/android. Thank you for watching.